everybody. Welcome to your strength Pilates session. And we are in a new room. I moved house. So we have a different location. I'm just in the process of trying to do it up at the moment. So we have a bit of sunlight coming through. So we might go in that bit of darkness, but that doesn't matter. As long as you've got your mat, you've got your weights, and we can crack on. Right, so we're going to start by standing back to our mat. I'm actually going to grab my weight. I'm going to start with my 4 kilos. This is kind of going to work nicely for a bit of a stretch, a bit of a starting kind of dynamic stretch. So we're going to start by standing with your feet underneath your hips. My toes are very subtly turned out to the side. Let's shoulder roll. Inhale up to the shoulders, up to the ears more like, and exhale, squeezing back behind. Inhale, exhale. So I'm just going to do 8 shoulder rolls. That's 5 and 6 and 7. Last one. And 8. And we're just going to let our arms drop down towards the floor, drop out the chin towards the chest, and just allow a little stretch out through the back of the neck. So I'm kind of allowing my weight to pull my arms down, at the same time lowering my chin towards my chest, and I'm just feeling that wonderful opening through the top of the neck and down across the tops of the shoulders. And I'm going to inhale, raise my head. Exhale, one more shoulder roll, keeping your weights where they are. We're going to do a light squat. Inhaling, dropping down. Exhaling, coming up. So my weights are just hanging down by the sides of my thighs. They just come gently down towards the sides of the knees as I push my bottom back behind. So I'm sinking down, like I'm about to sit down onto the chair, and then coming up. My eye gaze is elevated. My shoulders are still squeezed together at the back. My spine is straight. My abs are tucked in tight, and I'm just working a little bit of mobilization, waking up those muscles. Inhale. We're going for 4. First few don't really count. 3, 2, last one, and 1. Come all the way up, little shoulder roll. Take a breath in, and we're going to exhale, take our feet wider. So now I'm going to take my feet, my heels are on the edges of my mat, and my toes are turned out, so I'm in a plié squat position. And I'm going to slide my arms slightly behind me. So I'm bringing my weight, just tucking the back and squeezing the shoulder blade. And then I'm going to inhale, lower, down to the plié squat. So at the moment, my arms are comfortably tucked behind my thighs. But I have to activate the backs of my shoulders in order to keep my arms in that position. And then I'm opening out my knees towards my middle toe. If you feel like your knees are going further forward than your ankles, take your legs a little wider. So just have a look. Turn those toes out to that middle toe. Give me another 4, 3. Squeeze the belly, tap those shoulders back. Squeeze into your butt. Last one. And 1. Good. Just turn your right foot parallel and your left foot turned down. And then bring your weight inside the thigh and do a little mini bend and back up again. So I'm just sliding down into that hip, opening out through the inner thigh, coming back in. We're going to add a little bicep curl. So I'm going to drop down into that left leg, come up, left arm bicep curl. Squeeze, up. So I'm doing a nice long inhale here, exhale, bicep curl. 4 more. 3, 2, 1 more. And 1. Arm down. Slide that foot in. Turn out your right foot. I've got weight on top of my toes at the moment. Bring your right arm inside. My left arm just tucked slightly back. And we're going to bend out the bicep curl just to get a feel for this move on this side. pressing open that knee, following the middle toe, and then going into my right hip flex and my left leg is dead straight. Now I'm gonna add the bicep curl. Inhale, bend, exhale, curl in the middle. And if you feel like you're sliding around, by all means, take yourself lengthways on your mat so your feet are gripped on the mat. And then just do the exercise like that, because I can feel I'm slipping a little bit, actually. Four more. Notice how I'm staying upright through the body. I'm constantly squeezing my belly to keep the control through the legs. Last three. No, two. One more. And release. Bring those feet parallel. Bring your legs together, back underneath those hips. We're gonna bring those weights on top of our shoulders, or I'm just holding them lightly in front. Now, it depends if you've got light or heavy weights, you might wanna rest the heavy weights a little bit more on your shoulders. I've got 4 kilos, so you pick what works for you. To the backs of your mat. We're gonna inhale, we're gonna come back to that squat again. I'm gonna move my mat straight. So we're gonna inhale, drop down into squat, exhale, press up into a shoulder press. Inhale. Exhale, press. Losing sight of my arm there, aren't we? Can't get my camera angle right at the moment. But you know what I'm doing. My palms are staying facing in. Four more. Sinking back into that chair again. You can do this without weights, remember. See how your body's feeling. Use your legs to power out. One more. And then drop the arms down. Take a shoulder roll. Let the arms drop down towards the floor, drop your chin towards your chest and feel that stretch again. I'm just gonna put my jumper off whilst you're doing that stretch. So be heavy in the arm, bow the chin a little bit more, tuck it under and open up the front of your shoulder. Okay. Slowly raise your head up. Roll those shoulders. We'll go for another set. Weights on those shoulders. Let's see if we can go a little bit deeper this time. And if you wish, take the feet a tiny bit wider. So very softly turn the toes out. As soon as you take your legs a little bit wider than your hips, you get into the glutes, into the buttocks. So working a bit more into the outer thighs. So back into that chair. Power up. One. Down. Two. Three. Feel free to use whatever weight you want. Four. Five. Six. Seven. And eight. Last two. Nine. And ten. Drop your weights down. Yeah, we're gonna go back into that bicep. So we're gonna step our right leg forward and our left leg is left behind. Square your hips off so you're facing forward. We're gonna go into another bicep move. So we're gonna inhale to begin, exhale, down into a lunge, bicep curl, back up. Bicep curl, back up. Three, four, five, six, keep it going. Now we're gonna go for 20, seven. If you wanna stick to just the one arm, do just the one arm. When we get to 10, you can add the other arm in if you wish. So I'm gonna do one more on this side, then I'm gonna do 10 more. I'm gonna go a little bit deeper. Now remember your lunges, bending through both your legs to 90 degrees, keeping your weight in that front heel. If your knee goes further, over the front ankle, you've gone too far forward. Slide your stance a little bit wider if so. Reduce your range to there. If you're feeling like your knees and your hips aren't like it today, one more. Arms down. Step it in, swap it over. Straight over to the other side. Set yourself up first. Get your body position right, get your balance. Quite easier to kind of get a balance from staring into one spot. So find a place. Take a breath. Right, we do our right arm only. So we're dropping down into that left leg, curling the right arm for one, two, just have a look at that front knee, make sure it's not protruding inwards. 4, 5, 6. So if we do it all the way to 20, just working that one arm. You can carry on lunging and lose the arm if you need to, literally, or add the other one. 10 more, come on, keep that weight into that front heel, squeeze the belly, elbows press in towards the waistline. 3, 4, 5, and 6. Give me 4 more, come on, let's move this body. 4, tummy in. 3, last 2. Give me 1 more. And 1, good, step it forward. Give your legs a little shake. Now I'm further forward on my mat. Gonna inhale, put the chin to the chest. My weights are pulling me down softly, soften the knees. Come down to the floor so your weights land on the ground. And then use that lean into your weights just to bend and extend into the hamstrings. Extending one, extending the other. Side gaze between the legs. 4 more. 4 in the center, take a breath. 1 leg back, set the other leg back, and just stay here in a plank. So I've got my weights, my hands on the weights. You don't have to, you can put your hands flat down on the ground. I'm just gonna pause here, get a feel for the plank. Lengthen through the backs of the knees, push through the heels, pull your kneecaps up, squeeze the belly, squeeze the butt. Take one more breath here, and then we're gonna lower the knees down to the floor. Good. Now, here we are. You can drop down a lower weight. You can stick to the weight you've got. I've got a 4 kilo. You might want to drop it to 2. 1 might be a bit too light. You might want to just not do it anyway. Take your right weight out to the side. Right hand on the floor. Left arm slightly soft. So we've got that movement of sliding through. Knees wide, feet a little bit closer together. Abs on. We're going to exhale, raise up into a rotational swing. So I'm reaching my arms far up to 6 foot as I can, turning from my chest, rib cage, and keeping my hip bones as still as possible. Then I'm going to sweep it under, feed it in for 1. Squeeze up, look up, feed it under for 2. Under, 3, 4. And 5, pause here. I want to either take your body weight forward, step forward and lower your hips, or you can now lift your knees off the floor into a plank, and we're gonna go into a row, one arm row. So I lift up, I drop down. I'm trying to keep my hips as still as possible. So if you feel like you're wobbling around, don't feel stable, drop your knees, squeeze your butt and hold here. So from side view, we're working like that. Or you're here. 2 more. 1 more. And drop the knees down. Oh, I've got some light coming in today, haven't I? I can't escape with some light, I'm afraid. And then start again. Same arm, abs on. 1 last time round. We twist and we reach up. And we inhale. Exhale, feet under, hovering arm, bending through your right elbow. Left arm up. Make sure you've got your abs fully engaged. Breathe up. 3. Black magic. 4. Last one. And 5. Good. Drop down to the floor. Set yourself up for your rows. I'm lifting my knees again onto the side arm. And we row. 1. Tap the ground. 2. Tap the ground, your options here, knee down, 3. If your knees are down, don't pull your bottom up into the air, drop it down, squeeze it tight, abs engage. 5, 6, Siri's talking to me. 8, come on, squeeze, 9, 1 more. and 10. Drop it down. Release the weight to the side. Take a little breather. Make a little pillow. Come into a child pose. Or if you wish, curving the spine, your bottom off the ground. Find your breath. Now, slowly lift up. So I'm going to stay kneeling. I'm sitting back into my heels. You might not want to be in this position because sometimes the knees don't like that. So you can lift off and come up onto your knees. Okay, so you haven't got the pressure there. Grab your weight, both or one, depending on how strong you're feeling. We're going to do a tricep overhead. So weights together, raise your arms up, shoulders relaxed. Point your elbows to the sky. Inhale, bend your arms. Exhale, power up for one. Now, my core is feeling this because as I bend my arms back, my lower back wants to work. My abs are scooping in, sucking in to prevent my spine from doing that. So there my abs kick in now. And up, six, shoulders relax. Seven, come on, scoot the belly in, don't let that lower back arch, last two, power up, nine, and 10, drop your weights down, good. There's your little breather, and now we're going to work on the other side. So we're going to take the weight in our right hand, left hand on the floor, knees wide, feet together. So you've got that soft swinging motion through the arm. So we need that sunshine to go away, don't we? I don't want to wish away the sunshine that was coming here. Okay, so abs on tight, squeeze open through your knees. And then we're gonna inhale, exhale. The first one we're gonna hold up. So lift and lengthen and stretch and squeeze the belly. Get that 6 o'clock position through the arm. We inhale, swoop it under. Exhale, feed it under. Little pause. Inhale, exhale, breathe up. And feed it. Two, try and stick with my speed. Time under tension makes this so much harder. It really helps that range of motion. Two more. And with a 4 kilo, my muscles have to work hard. Last one. Oh, yeah, big lift up. And this time we float it through. And then we come back to center and release it off. Okay, so, look at that working in my forearm. And we're going to work them into those rows. So we're doing two sets. So remember, you can be on your knees, you can be on your toes. Lift up, abs on tight, and we pull up and down. My elbows pulling in, and then dropping to the floor. Options to be on your knees. If you feel like your hips are going a little bit wonky, six, seven, eight, nine, last one, and 10. Drop it down. Ease it off. Take a breath. Set yourself up back into that box position. Knees under hips, slightly wider. Abs on, that swinging arm, squeeze the belly, let's go. Inhale, exhale, up. One. Feed it under. And scoop it up. Two. Feed it. Three. Four. Lovely. Keep it going. Give me one more. Big, big lift all the way up, 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 up. And then release it under. Okay, always catch your breath. Let's start setting ourselves up for that row. Knees or toes, abs on, squeeze the butt, and we pull in for one. Tap the floor. Two, three, four, sideways, five, six, seven, last three, eight, nine, 10. And drop your knees down. Good. Just take a little sink back. Take your arms wide, reach your fingers. Now, the next exercise is going to be on our feet, and I'm going to take my light weights with me this time. Definitely take my light weights. So just tuck your toes, walk your hands into your feet, just take a little stretch there. Always nice to take a little stretch, extend those knees, wake those hamstrings up again. Scoop the belly in, with a soft knee you roll up, you stack the spine one by one. And always reset by rolling those shoulders. So I'm gonna show you this from a side on view. Now we're gonna work one side at a time. I'm gonna start by standing on my right leg and my left leg is just lightly back, touching the floor. That's gonna be my moving leg. So the moving motion is gonna be like this. I'm going to tilt forward like I'm doing a deadlift. So notice I'm just pivoting from my spine. My back stays flat, my arms are down here. And this is gonna be my moving leg, my leg at the back, my left leg. But I'm also gonna move my right arm. So that leg is gonna move and my right arm's gonna move. So I'm pivoting, my abs are strong. This arm stays stable and I'm gonna lift my arm and leg together. So I'm doing my right arm elevation, my left leg elevation, both extending. Extending through the hip, extending through the shoulder. Tapping down. And it's a stabilizing leg that's gonna feel the work. The sunshine has disappeared and my screen's gone dark. What's that all about? I hope you can still see me. 8, come on, pull it up. You can do this with no weight. Last one, and release. Give it a little shake. Woo! Hope you can see me still. Okay, so we set ourselves up on the other side. We hinge from the hip. My weight is going now into that left leg and my right leg is gonna be the moving leg. Okay, this is my left stable side and then my left arm is moving with that leg. So pivot forward, abs on. When you're ready, we lift up, we tap down. I need to focus a little bit more this side. You notice how my elbow and my knee are both bent. Come on, try and drop your chest a little bit lower. 3 more. 8. 9. Last one. And 10. Fabulous. Shoulder roll. Step back into your mat. We inhale, soften the knees, roll the chin down to the chest, and we're going back down to the floor. This time, once we land on the ground, we put our weights to the side, bring our fingertips down, knees down, and we are going to spin our feet around and kind of sit down. I'm going to move my mat. We're going to sit down the hot pool with our legs out in front of us. I'm going to move my mat a little bit more to this side, so I don't have the sunlight in my face. Whew. Right. So, take a little breather down there. Keep all your weights nearby. We're gonna do some moving exercises to the floor, back up again, and so on. And I just wanna make sure that there's still some light in the room. Woo! Without actually falling over my weight. Okay, let's do this. So we're gonna grab 4. Put your hands behind you, lean to the weight and just lift lovely and tall. I'm gonna take my legs straight out in front of me. Now, I'm going to bring my bottom further up towards my heels because we're gonna be going behind. So I'm sitting tall, my legs are bent, my feet are on the ground. I'm gonna turn my palms forward. I'm going to do a bicep curl with a palm turning forward rotation, a shoulder press, back down, turning my palms behind, and a bicep curl back to the floor. So that's, we're working two different movements, shoulders and biceps, okay? So you're gonna do 5 of these. I'm coming up to my third. I have a 4 kilo, more challenging for the shoulders and the biceps. You might wanna drop down. You might not want to use a weight at all. One more. This is my fifth one. I then lower my bicep curl down. I roll to the floor. I hit the floor. I bring my arm up above my shoulders and I bend my legs to tabletop. I'm going to lengthen my opposite arm to leg, kicking away for one, back into the middle, two, three, four, five, we're going to 10, six. If your arms don't like it individually, then drop a weight, take your arms together, or you can take your weights together. 8, 9, this really fixes in those upper abs, and 10. Drop your feet down. We're gonna roll the hips up into a bridge. Bring the knees a little bit closer together. Ground down through all four corners of your feet. Open your arms out and pull your arms back up for one. And if you wanna make your bridge a little bit harder, you can lift your heels. Otherwise, isolate and hold. 3, 4. So if you look at my arms, I'm making a C shape through like a half circle. And I'm keeping those elbows slightly bent. My forearms don't quite hit the floor, but the elbows tap down. 2 more, I think. I might have lost count then. Too busy talking. Hips up. Don't forget about that bridge. Squeeze your butt. Last one. And then roll it out. Lengthen the legs. Inhale, chin to chest. Exhale, let's roll it up. Bring the weights in towards your chest. Give you a little bit of a helping hand. Weights down behind you. Lift tall. So either lift your chest or you can lift your hips up. Just for a breath, roll it down. Sit yourself up, knees bent if you wish, palms forward. Inhale to begin, sit tall, exhale, curl up, turn, straighten out, drop, turn in, and down for one. If you wanna make this harder, you can just curve the spine very lightly behind you so your abs are then active. Your choice. Your core stillness needs to work when your back is straight because you're trying to use your core to keep your back straight. This is your last one. Then roll it down to the floor. You hit the floor, legs come up to tabletop, arms come up above the shoulders. I'm going to use both weights together as I kick one leg away. I'm going to move my arm behind me for one. So I'm not bending my elbows too much. I'm extending the shoulders behind me. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, last one, and 10. Pop the feet down. Keep them apart, hands above shoulders. Roll your hips up into that bridge. Lift your heels if you wish. Inhale, open up. Exhale, power up for one. And two. Knees together. 3, 4, 5, 6. Come on. 7, 8, 9. Squeeze your butt. And 10. Roll it out. Slide the legs, chin to chest, bend through the arms, roll it up, lengthen out, hands behind, lean back, shoulders squeeze behind, chest elevated, lift your hips if you wish, just for a breath, and then roll it out. So my arms have to go quite far back to get to that position. Okay, here we go. Last one. Sit tall, turn your palms forward. Bend your legs, keep them straight, scoot back if you need to, if you want more abs, curl, turn, press, bend, in and down. That's one. Two. Three. That's four, we've got one more here. And five, roll it out. Hit the ground, legs to tabletop, arms above your shoulders, bending slightly through the elbow and extending one leg as you pull the opposite arm behind or both arms. I'm moving from my shoulders. And as soon as I move more from my shoulders rather than my elbows, my upper abs have got to fire up a lot more. Six, back to nice and flat. Listen to your bodies. Seven. Eight. Nine. And 10. Drop your feet down. Slide them in. Roll your hips. Lift up into a bridge. Squeezing up through the butt. Lift your heels if you wish. I'm going to do my feet flat this time. Inhale, open your arms out. Exhale, curl up for one. And two. So this is a big muscle. It can do quite a lot. It can use more weight than you probably realize. So if you feel a bit easy, either open your arms a little bit more, or you can drop it to mid-range and do some little pulses instead. There's a little option for you if you wish. Okay, I've lost count again now. Eight, let's say. Nine, last one. And 10, roll it out. Drop your weights down. Just take a little breather here. Now, we haven't done the oblique work yet, so we need to work on these obliques. So when you are ready, we're going to set ourselves up. So we're going to do this just leaning over to one side slightly. I'm going to grab my smaller weights, one, and I'm going to be leaning with my arm out to the side slightly and then a little bit bent. So I'm leaning into it, but I'm not relying on it. Then I'm going to bring my weight to my shoulder and I'm going to sink back and pull my knees in. And then I'm going to reach my arm towards my toes and side squeeze into the side of my waistline. Then I'm going to kick my legs away and pull my arm back. And then I'm going to pull in, lift up onto that elbow and squeeze up into that side bend. Then lengthen everything away. Your core is still active there. You don't have to do the full extension. You may want to just bring your weight back to where we started here and then pull it in as you pull up. You may not even want to do double legs. You may want to rest your bottom leg and work, first of all, in this top leg and build up. You may want to drop the weight completely, still work with two legs, but work here. So whatever one you're doing, I'm dropping into my shoulder blade, lifting up onto my elbow, dropping down into my shoulder blade, lifting up onto my elbow. Four more. And three. Try not to hunch those shoulders. Two. Give me one more. And one. Let's hold this, shall we? Hold it, hold it out. Now squeeze through your belly, pull your thighs in. If you can, reach your arm up. And then if you can, extend your legs and hold. Five, four, come on. Two, and one. Just take a little release. Come up into this position. Take a breath, just like a kind of seated hurdle. Lean into that back arm and just lift that front arm and push your chest and hip forward as we're almost doing a backwards arch, reaching that arm back. Release the arm, come up, and let's set ourselves up the other side. So lean back into your hands, slide your bottom back, set yourself up on that other buttock, grab your weight, using your weight. I'm going to drop down into my shoulder blade, and then I'm going to lift up, pull my knees in, and set myself up. So I've just come from here, reach to my heel. So choose what works for you. Lengthen away, arms can come up and overhead, and then squeeze and pull in forward. I'll go through those options again. You can just bring your weight to here if you prefer, and then reach to your foot here, whether you're using your weight or not. Or you can keep that foot extension back. You may want to drop the lower leg and work that lower leg on its own. You're still going to feel your abs kicking in, you've just got a little bit more stability. Otherwise, you've just got to keep working as well you can with or without your weight. Let's do this. Come on. Pull up. Eight. Seven, right up onto that elbow, drop down into that shoulder blade. Six. And five. Come on, pull it in, scoop the belly in. Four. And three. Come on, come on, come on. Pull it in. Two. Last one. And one. Okay, tuck in, tuck in, tuck in, tuck in. Lift that arm. You don't have to, but if you can, extend the legs, hold it. Five. Lift the chest. Pull the thighs in. Last two. And one. Bend those elbows. Bend those elbows. Bend those legs. Come up into that seated hand. Slide that back arm. And just lift up the front of the body. Pull your chest forward. Lift up. Nice long deep breaths, just reaching. And then just release your arm. Bring yourself up to seated. Bring the soles of the feet together. And I want to slide your heels quite far away from you to create like a diamond shape through the legs. And then just let your head and chest drop down between the legs. Allow that give through your lower back. Allow that give through your hips. Nice long deep breath as you open the knees. Let the chin drop down. Now we did a couple of exercises very much related to our shoulder blades. So we're going to try and do a little bit of a shoulder blade stretch. So we're to bend your legs and flex your feet. And I want you to get your right hand around the outside of your left foot. And then you're going to just push that leg away from you. My hand here is just going to, I'm going to lean into it and I'm going to push that leg away. And as I push that leg away, it's pulling my arm away, which is then allowing that shoulder blade to open out and stretch. And if I just very subtly turn away from it, I feel that stretch more. So you have to kind of push the leg into your hand to allow that arm to pull away, the shoulder blade to open. So you need to kind of move to what place works for you. And then just ease it off. Get hold of your knees, lift up tall, just a little bit of a counter stretch for that forward flexion. And then we're going to catch hold of that right foot with the left arm and do exactly the same. I'm going to lean into my right hand, slide that leg away, lean and just turn and push the foot into my hand, which pulls my arm, which opens out through the spine, down to the shoulder blade. Excuse me, and just breathe here. One side will feel a little bit tighter than the other. Two more breaths. And then just carefully ease it off. Slide that leg back in, catch your shin, and lift it up tall. One more time into a hamstring stretch, taking your hands over the top of your feet. Lift and lengthen the spine and then fold forward, curl down and open out the backs of the legs, stretching there. And carefully release. Let's take a little stretch into the buttock. Lean into your arms, bend your legs, right foot over left knee. Bottom firmly on the ground, walk your hands in, lift your spine, elevate your chest, and then try and imagine you're driving your chest towards your thighs as you open up through that right knee, pulling your shoulders back and down. The more force you push through your arms, the more you'll get into that stretch. Nice long deep breaths. And then just softly bend through the elbows, allow the give through the spine. Slide that leg away, pop that foot down, swap to the other side. Flex the foot, lift your chest, shoulders back, and do exactly the same. You ground your bottom, you drive your chest forward using your arms, pull your shoulders back and down, elevate that chest, drive that knee away, Take a good few deep breaths here. One last breath. Ease it off slowly. Slide the foot off the knee. Wrap around the shin and lift up one more time. Here we're going to do a little curve into the spine again. So we're going to flip our feet back around behind us onto our hands and knees. And then just lift your chin, lift your bottom. Allow your spine to dip down the middle. Take a breath in, and then we're doing the absolute opposite, that suction up towards the spine, scooping the belly in, driving that through the shoulder blades, pushing the floor away, scooping up, and then allow your spine to come back to neutral. Tuck your toes, lift your bottom, with your hands to your feet. And just hang there, holding onto your elbows, and just hang side to side. Sway side to side. And then carefully just roll it up, stacking that spine. Gently, gently, gently lifting your eye gaze. Taking a deep shoulder blade roll. Feet together, open your arms. Lift up, squeeze back through those arms. I'm putting my shoulders back. And then bring your hands together, give yourself a bow, and always give yourself a little clap. Take some water, have a fabulous, wonderful rest of your day, and see you soon. Bye for now.